click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to see the characteristics of a separately excited DC motor, where we have seen separately excited DC motor in a previous video. We have seen the diagram, we have seen what are the parameters, and we have seen the two major mode of operation. What will happen, we are going to see now in those two mode of operation. Graph for the characteristics of a separately excited DC motor, where your x axis is nothing but speed and your y axis is nothing but, you can say, torque. It is a torque. So we are going to see how it is going to vary in a different mode of operation. So basically what I told you, if you remember the diagram, either you can change the armature voltage or you can change the field current to obtain the characteristics or to control the speed motor. So I have here, we have divided this graph in a two session, that is a constant torque region and constant horsepower region, correct? Now we will see how this constant torque, why it is known as a constant torque region, how torque remain constant, and why it is known as a constant horsepower region, because what happened here. So before that, I just want to show you the diagram one more time. This is the diagram we have seen. So first method I told you, that is the armature voltage control. So, and this particular armature voltage control is nothing but this section, that is from 0 to N base. N is nothing but speed. N will give you the turns. Basically you measure the speed of the motor in terms of a rotations, correct? So one rotation is a one, n is equal to 1, two rotation, n is equal to 2. So depending on the, whenever you measure a speed of the motor, so you take the rotation, you basically measure the rotation with one point, which is the standard point, correct? So that means if I have this rotating field, rotating motor, if I have this wheel, then there is a one point which is to be consider as a constant point. So if I started from this point, so once I'll complete my complete rotation, correct? So this is my one rotation. And in how much time it is taking this one complete cycle or one complete rotation, that is how I measure the speed of the motor. So that is nothing but N, and I will name this as a turns, how many turns it is taking in per second or per minute or per hour. That is how we measure the speed. So this section, you can see, that is a constant torque region, is an armature voltage control. That means here you are controlling, or here you are changing the armature voltage to control some parameters. And the second part, that is from N base to N maximum, and further you have a constant horsepower region. Here you have a constant horsepower, that means power consumed by the motor will remain same, but torque will change. Now whether it will increase, decrease, that we will see later, but in first torque will remain same, but here torque will, the value of torque will change, correct? So let's see the first, that is a armature voltage control. Now if you see this, in first method what will happen, I'll keep this armature current is constant, I'll keep this field current is constant, and I will only change the armature voltage. Now with the change in armature voltage, there will be change in a speed, or you can see there will be increase in a speed. Look at the graph here. This is, here I am changing the horsepower, correct? So if you see this graph, this is my armature current. This graph is for armature current. Armature current is kept constant. Field current is kept constant. And what I am changing? I am changing the armature voltage. Now if you see, if you consider this as armature voltage, again x-axis I am considering as an armature voltage. As my armature voltage increase, my horsepower will increase, correct? That means power by the DC motor is increasing as my armature voltage is increasing, and it will increase only till N base. This is the maximum speed, or you can say this is the maximum voltage where your horsepower will change and but your torque will remain constant. Correct? Because if you go on increasing the armature voltage, then this armature voltage can damage your device. If you go on increasing further, N base is the, you can say it is a threshold value. That means you can increase the armature voltage till this point. So if you increase till this point, your horsepower is also increasing. Correct? At the same time, your torque is constant. Your torque is remain constant, so it is also known as a constant torque region. Correct? Now let's see in the second. Now if you want to further increase the speed of the motor, what you can do is you cannot increase armature voltage, because if you do so, your circuit or your device may get damaged. Now to increase that, you have to change the field current. So that is the second method we are going to study. So second method is a field control. Or you can say field current control. That means in this diagram, I'll show you, this armature voltage will kept constant and you will change this IF, that is a field current. So field current, you can see it is traveling in this way, correct? In anti-clockwise, it is flowing. So if it is flowing anti-clockwise, speed will vary according to the field current. So if the field current decreases, then your speed will increase. Now let's see here in this diagram. You can see from N base, your field current is started decreasing. It is decreasing till N max, correct? While it is decreasing, your speed is increasing only, correct? Because this is your speed line. This is X axis is your speed, correct? If your field is decreasing, at the same time, your speed is increasing. But at the same time, your torque is also decreasing. If you see from this line, your torque is also decreasing. That means I have kept my armature voltage fixed or constant. I am changing the field current. That is what I am decreasing the field current. If I am decreasing the field current, my speed will increase, but at the same time, my torque will decrease. Now, due to this condition, you can say your power will remain constant, because at the time when your torque is increasing, your speed is at the time where your torque is decreasing, your speed is increasing. Here you can see, that means it is making balance of power, because your power is nothing but the calculation of a torque into speed. If one parameter is increasing, at the same time if this other parameter is decreasing, then that particular ratio or that particular term will remain constant. So here the name for this field is given as a constant horsepower region. Have you understood why it is divided into two? First of all, when I change the armature voltage, I am not doing anything with my separately excited field. Field current is a constant. At that time, if I go on increasing voltage, my speed will increase and torque will remain constant. So that particular region is either called as an armature voltage control or constant torque. After N base, if I kept on increasing armature voltage, it may damage. So I cannot go with that method. So my second method is I'll keep that armature voltage is a constant and I will change the field current. If I'm changing the field current, with the decrease in a field current, the speed will increase as well as torque will decrease. So torque into speed is nothing but my power. So one is increasing and one is decreasing. So multiplication of this both will remain constant. So this region can name is a constant horsepower region. This region is also a name as a field weakening region, because here my field is quite will weak down because my field current is decreasing. So if my field current is decreasing, my field will get weakened. So this is also can be called as a field weakening region. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Do subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you so much.